Well, still intermittent gunfire echoing around this part of the city that we're in. So the fighting and apparently the looting is not completely over yet. It's calmed down a lot, and a day of incredibly dramatic developments as Laurent Gbagbo, who was hunkered down in a bunker underneath the presidential palace where he'd been for almost a week, was finally flushed out. His side, the Gbagbo side, claim it was French special forces that went in and got him, but the UN and the French are insisting it was in fact forces loyal to his rival, the current president, Hassan Ouattara, who went in and got him out. We understand he's now at the Gulf Hotel, which is where President Ouattara has been to camp out ever since this standoff started after the elections back in November. So at the moment, Gbagbo has come out and urged his followers to lay down their arms, but from what we're hearing on the streets, all of them are doing that yet.
It was very, very bloody, Dan. Now, how many people, is it estimated, died since November, the election in the Ivory Coast?
We just don't know, but I mean, we're looking at hundreds and possibly thousands. I mean, in one incident alone up in the northwest in Dukwe, there was a report of 200 people being allegedly massacred. Now, the people there were saying to local reporters that they claim it was Alassane Ouattara's side, the current president's side, who were involved in the massacre, has vehemently denied that. So there will clearly have to be an investigation in that. Human Rights Watch has come out and talked about trying to launch an investigation into that particular incident. But overall, you're right, this has been an incredibly bloody few weeks here in Ivory Coast. We're a country teetering on the precipice of all-out civil war. It has been pretty much a war, urban warfare here in Abidjan, the main commercial city. As we drove in here this evening, there was plenty of evidence of lots of smashed-up buildings and looting. And as I say, we've still been hearing intermittent gunfire this evening, and pretty much no one out on the streets. There is still a curfew in place. The big question now really is whether Gbagbo's followers, the militia, and particularly the young militia that have so terrorized parts of the city, whether they will now lay down their arms.
Dan Rivers, another one of our courageous international correspondents. Dan, be careful over there in Abidjan. We'll stay in close touch with you.